Town now. My friends just bought a restaurant slash bar, and we're going to open it up for him. He invited me now to go and open it up, so we're ready. So yeah, we're going to the Fresh Kitchen. It's a good mate of mine, Sean, sponsor of mine actually, and that's where we're going.
You cutting the ribbon?
Yeah, I believe so. Official, huh? Yeah, I think it's all official. So we'll give him a bell in a second.
Don't you and the Queen do stuff like that?
She was busy.
Yeah, Starkey's fan. There it is. That's Starkey's fan. And many a my breed of person come down this old road. Yeah.
It's me and Nick from school this when we was children. Got to come here. And used to use this little school. It's where we used to come. And we went here from being about 6 till 11. Was it? Yeah.
Did you leave school at 11, Rick?
Yeah, done. Yeah, all over.
Most travelling kids leave school at 11. Don't go into high school, go and get some work with families.
Yeah, you go out and do what you gotta do, whatever it be. I told you it was like Hogwarts, no? I wasn't joking. What?
Primary school. What? Good memories.
Unbelievable. Best school dinners in the country in there. I'm telling you. Never mind, everyone probably say that, but my God. Bear in mind, you're in the country, yeah? You got country food.
Yes.
Had steak and ale pie, man, and all sorts.
Jesus, we did get that.
Honest to God, steak and ale pie, vegetables stacked up to anything. And you know when you could always have seconds?
Yeah.
Could have fifth, sixth in there if you wanted it. Okay. If you could eat it. I'm telling you, I wonder if he was heavyweight.
Yes.
Get these to him. This is my nephew's, my cousin. Come here, say hello. Look who's arrived. There you go. Don't be long. Obviously, this is Sean, man, who owns this. I thought it was a younger man.
Yeah,
are
you
like,
long
turn around.
Together?
Say hello. So, hello. Yeah, cousin. Oh,
introduce
nephew. Yeah, introduce us. Young Lewis, young Ruben. With him all the time. With me all the time. All the time. Going on marathon runs. All the time. When I do crazy marathon runs, these are the two psychic partners who come with me. Two good boys. Both can box. Both like
boxing.
Yeah, of course I do. Fucking love it. Animals. Come up here. We're going to have a bit of scran. We're going to sit down with me. We're going to talk. A load of nonsense. There's PlayStation games up there. Probably be having a fight in a minute over the FIFA. Say look, they love it, don't they? So yeah, they're all down here. So lovely. Perfect. Come on, let's get up there. Kitchen, the two boys, they've just opened up upstairs, this restaurant. Sean Mooney,
nice to meet you.
Paul, both of my sponsors. Yeah. You know, so yeah, these boys, you know, they help me a great deal, especially in my life, I tell you. Honestly, they help me out with all my meal preps and stuff, so big help for the boxing. Really mean that, very big help for the boxing.
Unless he's eating fries.
Yeah.
Well, tell us that's why we're here tonight. It's a grand opening of this new venture that you're going into, Sean.
Our second venue, just opening up, so kicking it off how we want to. Hopefully we can get a lot of people down tonight. Hopefully
we can
eat all the food.
God bless it. Eat a bit of food, yeah. And it's you're working with Ricky, you're supporting him in his boxing journey. So for a heavyweight boxer, what kind of fuel and food are you putting into Ricky? What sort of stuff you feeling he needs, you know, on a day-to-day basis?
He likes to mix it up. So
you like cake?
It's different. He has about 3 crunchies as a starter.
get me in the gym, rip me hair off. No, Terry, rip me legs apart.
He likes his salmon and especially his omelettes. Yeah. He's an omelette man, so fuel the big fella up.
Yes. Yeah. So, buzzing. You know, it's good. You know, exactly. You see, we're just all the same group of lads, you know what I mean? We just want to see everyone get on well. These lads want to see me get on well with the boxing. I want to see them do well with the business. You know, they've got other business as well. SP Painting, what's doing marvellous. You know, these lads, you know, they're very good lads.
They're supporting you and you're supporting them tonight.
Yeah, 100%. Exactly how it works. Works hand in hand, doesn't it, at the end of the day, you know?
They usually guys get behind the journey. It's not long till Ricky's pro debut as well, so all looking forward to that and seeing Ricky go on this boxing journey.
Can't wait. Hopefully he kicks off a big win.
Yeah, big knockout win.
First round knockout.
That's what we want. Big dirty first knockout win. You know, if that's the way it's gotta be. So looking forward to it. You know, we're doing really well. Everything's going to plan in training. Got fights coming up this year. I've got 3 fights booked in for this year. Been the unluckiest man in the world, really, when it comes to fights. I really have, you know, changing the managers, all sorts of different crap. But now, listen, I'm in a good place. I'm a really good manager. I'm with a boxing family. What more do you want at the end of the day? You know what I mean? So, start my career off on a nice big win. Get back in here, celebrate. Get up, my boy!
A bit of food there,
didn't
we?
Yeah.
We did. We smashed it out, didn't we? It was a good do.
You know he's had a good do because the vest has come out.
Yes.
He just can't keep the guns hidden, can he? Can't keep them away now.
you've been working on them?
Oh, yeah.
They weren't as big as that before.
It wasn't like that, was they?
I owe that all to James Mack.
You give us a nice little tour of Chester?
Yeah, you've had a little look at Chester.
We have.
Pretty little place, isn't it?
That's nice.
We've just seen a few pretty little places today, Aki.
Yeah,
as the boys will tell you, haven't we, boys?
Absolutely, yes.
You know, you and the boys have been on it, like, you know, you've been on a mission since about 1 o'clock, haven't you?
Yeah.
I've just joined late to the party.
Yes, we don't mess about. But I'm happy you're here. It's been a long time since being this man's been united.
Good to see you all.
Yeah.
Good to see you, Ricky.
Good to see you too, man. 3 fights lined up before Crimbo. Boom.
We'll be talking about Ricky Gorman versus whoever.
Whoever in the very near future.
Stay tuned.
What match? Central area. I can fight very quick.
Chris Gorman, give us a wave because he's been quiet the whole journey.
Yeah, go on, Chris.
give us a song, the backing track in the back.
But in my own private episode of BBTV.
So, yes. Yeah. Very good.
Got to listen, aren't you?
We've been on the road again doing a bit, haven't we? So another long day and a late night.
Yes, to see you, boys.
Go on, boys. God bless.
Thanks for driving.
And so we're underway. Nathan Gorman in those black and gold trunks would love a fast start here against a fighter who does have 11 wins inside 3 rounds. And as Richie talked about, carries some power, but the question is, does he carry it?
Well, it's a big night tonight, Ricky, the boxing. Nathan's on tonight, your brother.
Yes, he is.
He's well on with his career now, and he's got a title fight tonight.
Yeah, IBF International, 20th professional fight. You know, listen, it's a good big statement here for tonight. Put on a good show in front of this good Liverpool crowd. Get out there and go and enjoy it, big man. This is it, it's your time. He'll rank you really well in the world rankings, top 15. So it's time to get out there and do what he does. Like every other man, like I've always said, like if you're a builder, if you're a joiner, if you're a painter, go out there and do the best you can as you trade. And that's up to him tonight, and won't put on his best performance.
Yeah. Have you seen much of Nathan in camp, and how is he looking? How's he, more mentally, how is he feeling with it? Like, you know, he had that Dubois loss, yes. And then he's had to rebuild himself, and is he like a different fighter now coming back? He looks different in the way his demeanour.
Exactly, yes, I couldn't agree with you more. Yes, so he's found more of a platform with his mindset. He seems to be right fundamentally. He seems to be got good foundations behind him. So all we're looking forward to is tonight, is watching him get out there, put on a stellar performance, and see a new and improved Nathan Gorman for the heavyweight division. That's what we're here to see. You know, we're going to see, hopefully, God willing, a nice new Nathan Gorman, which I know that's what we're going to see. You know, I've seen what's been going on behind closed doors. I've seen what's been going on with the sparring. I've seen what's been going on in the camp. He's looking well. He's looking strong. And this kid who's come here to fight, he's came here to win. He hasn't come here to play around. He's coming on off a two fight win streak. He ain't coming here just to come in here and get his money and tuck up in a corner and run away. You know, he's a big kid. He looks in shape. He looks lean. And why not? It's the heavyweight division. He only has to clip in with one and vice versa. But I've got full faith. And I mean that full faith in my heart and full faith in my mind. My brother's going to pull through it. And I think it's going to be by a stoppage win.
Really bad shape for that fight against Daniel Dubois mentally with what was going on. This is the real Nathan Gorman. Chopping right hands, Alec.
Nathan Gorman, who's just produced a first round blowout, mate. Talk us through that. It was an impressive performance.
Yeah, definitely. Tough kid, you know, we expected to go. I planned for the stoppage for maybe four or five rounds, something like that. But we got the win. We got it out there pretty good style, I think. I felt him go in the first 30, 40 seconds. I thought it was a good shot around the side of the ear. And I felt his legs buckle. And I thought I'd just put the pressure on you. That's what happened, and thank God I got the victory.
You've been out for a while, you know,
is it a long time? Inactivities. It could be a good thing and a bad thing, but you know, it's not very good. There's nothing like fighting. You can spy, you can do what you want, there's nothing like fighting. To get your, hence the word, fighting fit. You can't beat it.
Yeah. I mean, is it a worthy opponent? You know,
look at the resume the man's got. You know what I mean? The people he's been in with and things. When he's got beat, he's been four rounds. You know, and he's only lost twice to a big, highly tutored German kid who won the Youth Olympic Games. You know, I had 12 amateur fights. You know what I mean? Yeah, granted, I won the ABAs and things like that, but that's nothing, is it? 12 amateur fights. Yeah. And then he lost to Casherly for a European title. Casherly's been around a long time. I'm 25 years of age, so I'm pleased with it. I don't think no one has done that to him, have they? So.
Here we are.
It's me.
Let's have a look.
Strapping fella. A strapping dog for a strapping man. What a performance, son. Proud of you. Proud of you. Honest to my God, look at that.
Couldn't get any better. A first round knockout. Boxed really well. What a performance. What a night for him. It's shooting him in the top 15 in the world. He's cuddling the belt like cuddling a newborn baby. So is he happy with it? I take that as a big yes. Was everybody happy with the performance? How could you get much better? Heavyweight comes in and gets a first round knockout for you. You're not getting much better than that, are you? You know. So looking at it, the whole picture, you're getting it all. And the 30 seconds of fights lasting, I've lost my voice. So I've done some screaming. I've done more screaming than an opera singer. But fantastic performance. Fantastic way of going on. Listen, it doesn't get much better than that. He's had a long time out of the ring. He's come back against a live opponent with a good few knockouts on his record. The man come there game. When you're hitting a man and it's going through the guard, you're hitting with tremendous power. We can all see Nathan's a big, strong man. He's like a caveman. Look at him, his hair's all over him. He reminds you of something out of the 1000 year BC. All he's missing is a bone in his hand. But good on him and good luck to him and fair play to him. Listen, the other Gorman's just took his belt. The other Gorman's making his debut. And look here. Where are you? 300 years of that. And good luck to him. I don't look like much of an athlete eating one of them right now, do I? There you go. I'm very late and I'm very hungry. And heavyweight's got to eat. What do you say, boys?
So come on then, Ricky. Are you ready for this?
Catch.
Can you feel the benefits yet?
I feel the benefits. I can't feel my kneecaps. Oh, God. Ooh. Yes. Look. Oh, my God. It's cold. God bless us. I'm telling you.
Okay, go.
Oh.
Oh.
Straight away though, instant. Like he said, it's a mental thing now. Straight away, bang. You're in a fight now. Honest to God. It's warm in this room, isn't it? No, son? No? No? It's warm in this room. But I can assure you, this is cold. This is what it is, ice. It's like being tucked in a bag of ice cubes.
Yes.
Worse. Oh my God. It's like I'm in the Antarctic.
The birds.
How often do you do this?
Well, I used to, when it was in the gym, I try and use it quite frequently. But it's been a while. So, because obviously when the one come out of the gym, it's been a while. But I only got introduced to this, really, maybe 8 months. 8 months. But these boys are doing marvellous, you know. I thank them. Look what they're doing for you, you know what I mean? And SJJ. Because if it wasn't for SJJ contractors, you know, none of it would be possible to do what I do. I really mean that, yeah. Honestly. Honest to God. But it's like anything though, Chris. I mean this, right? If you've got a good dog, whether it be a good lurcher or whatever it is, or say for instance you've got anything in life that's any good, you've got to take care of it. If you don't take care of it, it won't be good, will it? It'll eventually break. It's like having a lovely watch. And you know, it's like having that good watch and you know the battery's going on it and not replacing the battery with it. Break. You know what I mean? It's the same for this. And that. It's the exact same. Well, I thank all my sponsors, though, Chris. I say it all the time, you know, because good people don't go unnoticed, do they? They don't. Good people don't go unnoticed. So I thank them undoubtedly, you know. Because you've got these boys, you've got SJJ, help me unbelievable. You've got the Mercedes specialist next door to the gym, where I'm at training. They're there. I've just had another sponsor just come on board, the scaffolding king, my pal, Brad Smythe. He's a good mate of mine. He's just started sponsoring me, you know. So it's going to be a good journey. What a journey I'm on. I've had some hiccups in the road, God knows I have, but it's all preparation. At the end of the day, I'm a mentally strong man. I'm not gonna bow under because I've had a couple of bad things happen to me over all of a sudden. It's not about that, it's about now. I'm on the right track, everything's sorted. I've got this manager, he's getting me the fight. I'm gonna fight, and that's it. And I'm just gonna climb this rankings of the heavyweights and get in there and do what I gotta do. Now I'm relaxed, it's not as bad. First jumping in, it's got to give me free.
We just want to help out, obviously, all the lads and helping the community, really. It's not just about, obviously, the recovery and everything that we're doing. It's about building a community and putting back into our community, which Si's been working with, the CIC, which is the charity arm of the business, about helping people with mental health in the town as well. So there's a lot of different aspects to what we're trying to build here.
Yeah, that's fantastic to hear. And I don't know a lot about ice baths. I've seen it's getting more prevalent in boxing as well. Boxers are using it for recovery. Can you tell us a bit about it, Si, now, you know, how it does work and benefit boxers?
Yeah, of course. Obviously, for the boxers side of it, it's about the recovery. It lets them train harder the day after. These lads are putting in a lot of time and effort, especially at the grassroots level, and they're still having to work as well. So for them, they don't really have the time for the recovery. So always giving them this chance to come here, getting the ice bath after training or when they're feeling a bit tired, it just makes them be able to go again the day after, makes the training better, make the camps better, just coming through a lot stronger with it through the end of it. But then on the other side of it, then we have got the mental health aspect, so it does teach you a bit of mental toughness. As soon as you jump in that ice bath, the initial thing is get out, we don't want this, let's get out. So give yourself breathe, get yourself through it, start getting used to it, start feeling better, so your mental toughness goes up. So, but again, for the boxers, when they're in that hole in sixth round, when they're stuck right in the middle of it, yeah, it's going to help them on that way as well.
That pain. Thank you.
any person, you know, who watches BBTV, any person who watches, you know, At Home with the Gormans, you know, if you're struggling in life, if you're a bit down, if you're a bit depressed, if you're not you, best thing I'd offer to anybody in advice is reach out. We can't take everything in life on our own. You know, you see, my old lot's got a saying, my back's broad enough to bear it. But there comes a time in life when some things can overfill a cup. It's like water with a cup. It can hold what it can hold. That cup's a good cup because it can hold what it can hold. If that's still pouring, eventually it overflows. So that's when you need to help. And that's the truth of it. That's when the next person comes into it. And that's what you need. St. Peter, you know, in the Bible it states, with St. Peter, on St. Peter I build my church on you. And as you can read here, now you might have to forgive me here with some of my reading skills, but it says, "Oh God gave St. Peter, a Capuchin priest, the great privilege of participating in the unique way in the passion of the of your son. Grant me through his intercession the grace of which I ardently desire, and above all grant me the grace of living in confidently with the death of Jesus to arrive at the glory of the resurrection." I do apologize for the reading, but that's St. Peter. So when we all see each other at the gates, that's the gentleman who's gonna, you know, open up for you and let you go with the blessed Lord. So, amen. I'm a Catholic, and whatever religion you are, I do not mind at all. As long as you got faith, as long as you believe, you know, as long as you got faith and you're not a bad person, you're not a corrupt person, you're not evil. And I believe, you know, we all have our own trials and tribulations at the end of the day. And this is what I believe, and I wouldn't judge the book on if someone else believes something different, because I just wouldn't do that. That's not my way of being. You know, there's no such thing in what's right and what's wrong in that regards to religion or faith or whatever it is. No. Let people do what they want to do. As long as they're not being criminally weighed or wrong-minded or with a bad attitude or a bad mindset, that's fair enough. At the end of the day, we all have to meet a maker in the end. So I just hope to God that whichever one it is, whoever it is we're going to see, I hope to God he looks down on me, this servant, and says, "You know what, you tried, you give a go, so come on, you come up here." You know, but that'd be nice, you know what I mean? So it's all we can do, but to give your best, and to know you have to give your best, and you know you've tried, that's good going. That's very good going. That's a lovely thing to say that you've given your shot, you've given it all. There's these lovely birds in the trees, isn't this? You know what I mean? You know, this ain't worldly possessions here. This is it, as good as it gets. I ain't got a pair of shoes on my feet. When my grandfather was alive, he wouldn't be too pleased with me walking down with no shoes on. No, old people don't believe in that, but for this walk, that's what you got to do. So I know, I understand how you'd feel with this. But that's it, you know. My grandfather, you know, he's a Catholic man and believed very strongly in his faith. Now, I don't believe in nothing evil. You know, I wouldn't... where's this come from? You know what I mean? You wouldn't know who that is that's come to say hello, would you? You know, it's a funny thing. It's a funny thing. Life's a funny thing. I'm a bit of an eccentric person in me ways. I am a bit eccentric. I can't help it. That's who I am. And to change that from me, I wouldn't be me no more. You know, my grandfather was the same. We're all the same. All my people's the same. We're all eccentric. We're all not right. Well... You know, look here.
Catching.
If that ain't a cousin, I don't know what isn't. You know, it's lovely. It's nice. This is life. And you know something? This will get easier on your feet in a minute. This will get easier.